You'll hear a lot about the tangent normal coordinate system. Now, it plays on the strength of what we've just done here, this curvature, and all these things actually go together, and you're going to use them together, so let's go for it. First things first, though, I just want you to consider a circle. Consider a circle, circular motion, goes round and round and round. It is the only kind of movement that, that's one horrible circle. Anyway, it's the only movement that you can find in which the magnitude of the position vector never changes. It just, as it goes, the magnitude, this radius there, just stays constant all the time. So it's the only type of movement that you can really think of in which, in this initial reference frame, where this, the magnitude of this position vector never changes. And as such, its first derivative, the velocity vector, at any point is always going to be perpendicular to that. The position vector and the velocity vector are always going to be perpendicular. And for us to look at a body coordinate system, now imagine we've all seen these action cameras mounted on a helmet, on a motorbike or bicycle, and it's as if the helmet of the person is absolutely still. That's a body coordinate system, and this whole world is moving around. Now imagine if you are in a particle, a point moving along this trajectory, as far as you are concerned, you have your own coordinate system. And the whole world is moving around you. And that is a coordinate system that is different from this world view, this Cartesian coordinate system. That's a body coordinate system, a coordinate system that is going to remain static for from the point of view of someone or something on that body, on that particle that moves along. So for that we have this tangent normal, binormal. It's actually some people put the B in, and I'll show you what the binormal unit vector is. That is a coordinate system that is fixed on this moving particle, and as far as it's concerned, the whole world is moving around it. Now we already know this tangent normal vector. The tangent normal vector is just the norm of the velocity vector. So at any point that I can, that I have a position vector, at any point that I have a position vector, I take its first derivative and I have the velocity vector. In other words, I have r prime of t. That is the first derivative there. And if I just expressed its magnitude divided by its magnitude, r prime of t, so I have a unit vector. If I do that, its length becomes 1, and all it now shows me is the direction, and that is the tangent normal vector. We've seen that, the tangent normal vector. Now, I want to construct, as I have with a Cartesian coordinate system, I have here, it is perpendicular to each other, so I want to construct the same sort of thing there. So at this point, I want, if that's my t of t there, I want something that is perpendicular to that at any time, and I'm going to call that the principal normal vector. It is perpendicular to that. And at any point, I sort of instantaneously want to see that as this sort of scenario. If I have a position vector and I take its first derivative in this sort of scenario, which is happening instantaneously at every kind of point, you can see it as something like that, I want this kind of scenario so that this is my t and this is my n. And what do? I take the derivative of that. So we're going to have this principal normal unit vector, principal normal unit vector, that is going to be for us t prime of t over its magnitude. So again, it's going to have a length of 1. So what it basically tells us, it's a prime there, it goes together with it's the derivative of that, divided by its magnitude, just to make it unit vector again. But it shows us for this type of scenario. Now, don't mistake this for this. This particle is not moving in a circle. But as it stands right at the spot, viewed as instantaneously as looking like something like this, And if you were to do this, we can do a problem, or you can do problems where you can just take the dot product of these two vectors, and it's going to end up being zero. In other words, they are perpendicular to each other. Now you can well imagine in two-dimensional space that this normal principal normal tangent vector can point in this direction, or it can point in this direction. And what it tends to do is it always points in the direction in which this is changing. If the slope is changing in this direction at the moment, okay, so it's concave looking from this side, it's going to point in that direction. Over here, suddenly it's going to swap over looking in that direction. In three-dimensional space, it's actually even more difficult, because it can now not only point in one of two directions, but it can point anywhere in a circle. And there is something called the osculating circle, and the circle in the plane. We needn't be too concerned about these things now. But what the point of it all is that this usually points in the direction in which the curvature is going at the moment. Okay, it's easy enough to see. And then we have this binormal unit vector B that you just have to know about, and that is just the cross product. That is just the cross product of these two vectors. Just the cross product of those two vectors. So nothing here is too difficult, too sinister. Now we are going on to another form of another derivation, so that you have another equation to play with to determine curvature. And for that, we're going to make use of this tangent normal or body coordinate system that stays with the particle wherever it goes.